starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
You could have gotten yourself killed, crossing the street and all that traffic. And besides, what are you doing out here alone anyway? I wonder where Bob is.
I thought something had happened to you.
Something almost did.
Where'd you find him, Timmy?
Downtown.
Gosh, thanks for bringing him home. I sure thought I'd lost him.
What was he doing on there all alone anyway, Bob?
I didn't know he was gone. I left him home when I went to look for a job. He must have tried to follow me.
He almost got hit by a car. Two cars. He was winding around like he couldn't see where he was going.
He couldn't see where he was going. He's blind.
Blind?
He's got cataracts.
Cataracts? What's that?
It's something that grows over the eye, kind of like a film. Finally, it closes off all the light. Then you can't see anymore.
Gosh, I'm sorry. But that doesn't keep him from being a swell dog.
I know. But my dad says the farm's no place for a blind dog. Too many things could happen to him. Dad wants him to be put to sleep.
Well, can't Doc Weaver do anything about it?
Yeah, he can operate.
Why don't you let him?
Because it costs money, and we can't afford it. I tried to get a job, but nobody seems to think I can do a day's work in the fields because I'm a kid.
I bet my dad would hire you. I forgot he's away on a business trip.
Well, I better be getting on home. Thanks again, Timmy, for bringing Butch back.
That's okay.
I'll be seeing you.
You better be careful, Mom. You might put your back out. And after all, you're just a woman, and you're not very strong.
Just a woman and not very strong. Now, you've got something brewing around in that head of yours. Come on, out with it.
Well, I was thinking that we better hire somebody to help out, especially while Dad's gone.
I suppose you have someone in mind?
Uh-huh. Bob Alder. He's been looking for a job, and he's going to use the money to fix Butch's eyes. And he's 14, and he's real strong.
Well, I don't know. I think you might have a good idea.
With all this corn to be picked and the preserving to be done, it might be handy to have someone like Bob to help while your father's away.
I'll go get him right away.
Whoa!
But he can start to work right away.
Well, don't you think the proper thing to do would be to get Bob's father's permission?
I suppose so.
Well, we'll go over first thing in the morning.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
Here we are. Okay, now. One more. Ready?
Don't let Mr. Oliver know that Bob said they didn't have much money.
Oh, no, 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 I won't. I'll be tactful.
Hello, Mr. Alder.
Howdy, Mrs. Martin.
Hello, Bob.
Timmy? And I hear Paul's still away.
Yes, as a matter of fact, that's why Timmy and I are here.
Well, is there something I can do for you?
Well, I came over to ask if you'd let Bob work at our place for a few hours each day.
Well, if Bob wants to take on the work, I have no objections. What do you say, son?
I'd be glad to hire out to you, Mrs. Martin. I can do most anything on a farm.
See what I tell you. I mean, I'm sure Bob can do a good job.
Yes, I'm sure he can.
But don't take on any more than you can handle, son. And you're not to neglect your own chores, you know.
I won't, Dad.
Thanks, Mr. Alder. We appreciate it very much.
Oh, is it all right if I bring Butch along? Dad hasn't time to watch him.
Sure. And Lassie will be his seeing eye dog. Won't you, girl?
I think Butch will be well supervised.
Come on, Lassie, and bring Butch.
Thanks, Dad.
It's all right, son. You can use the money toward Butch's operation.
Bob, now you and Timmy start filling those crates with corn.
Yes, ma'am.
Then what do we do?
Oh, well, that'll take you most of the day, and when you're finished, send Lassie back, and I'll bring the pickup, and we can load it.
Okay.
Mom, I guess I was wrong about Mr. Alder. He isn't mean at all.
Well, I guess maybe you shouldn't judge people too quickly.
Now listen to me, Butch. You got to behave like a real good dog and not cause the Martins any trouble. This is our big chance to get some money so we can have your eyes fixed.
Lassie, taking care of a blind dog is a big responsibility. But I can depend on you. Woo! I'm thankful your eyes are good.
We'll be ready to load.
Yeah. Come here, Lassie. Now you go back to the hospital and get Mom, okay? Well, hurry.
Thank you.
I must say, you boys have done a good job.
Where's Butch? I hope he's not lost again. Butch! Butch!
Maybe he tried to follow Lassie.
Maybe he's in the cornfield.
I've got to find him.
She picked up Butch's trail.
Well, we'll take the pickup. We can keep up with her that way.
Butch is drowned.
Where's Butch, girl?
It's no use.
Oh, now, let's not jump to conclusions. All dogs are natural-born swimmers.
But Butch couldn't see where he'd be swimming to.
Yeah, maybe he got out so far he couldn't get back. Butch must have gotten out, Bob. Lassie's picked up the trail again.
I'll be able to see better from the back.
Thank you.
Lassie's gonna cut him off.
Looking for something? How big it on there? Would you mind explaining what's going on here?
Well, I'm not quite sure myself, but it looks as though you accidentally scooped up a little dog. A blind dog.
He's mine.
And Lassie belongs to me.
I think just to be on the safe side, we better have Doc Weaver check both Butch and Lassie. Make sure they're all right.
Thanks for helping, mister.
Okay.
Come on, Lassie.
Doc Weaver said the sooner Butch's eyes are operated on, the better his chances will be to have the operation successful.
And they're only going to charge for the use of the operating room.
Well, I'm sure he'll keep the cost just as reasonable as possible.
And I won't have to pay it all at one time.
Well, you know, son, I've always been against going into debt. But in this case, I think we can work it out somehow, together.
You know, girl, if it weren't for you, Butch wouldn't even be here at all.